Namaskaram. Today, now next we are going to start chapter number 5, that is fraction. Okay, and what is the fraction? To divide any whole thing into the number of parts. And taking out some parts from the total parts. Okay, see that this is known as the fraction. How I am going to explain you here. Suppose one circle is there and we have divided this circle into 8 smaller parts. How many parts, beta? In 8 smaller parts. And out of these 8 parts, how many we have taken? If you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. And out of 8, if suppose these 2 we have taken, then the taken part comes in numerator. Taken parts upon total parts. Okay, taken parts upon total parts. How many parts I have taken out? 2 parts. How many parts I have divided the whole circle? 8. That's why this fraction will become 2 upon 8. The fraction will become 2 upon 8. And taken parts always becomes numerator. What we say in math? Numerator. And total parts is known as the denominator. And the whole process is known as the fraction. Whole thing is known as the fraction. Okay, now just see, in this way you can divide. Suppose you have a square box or rectangular box and you are dividing it into 4 parts. Out of that, 1 part I have taken. So what will be the fraction that I have taken? Means taken part is 1. In how many part I have divided the whole rectangle in 4 part. So it will be the fraction, means the which part I have taken, that it means 1 upon 4 part of the whole thing. 1 upon 4th part of the whole thing I have taken. Here out of whole things, how much part I have taken? 2 upon 8 part I have taken. This is known as the fraction. So in this way, many things you have to given represent the following fraction in your notebook using any plain geometrical shape. Okay. Already I told you, upper part of the fraction is known as the numerator and lower part of the fraction is known as the denominator. Represent the following fractions. Now come to the exercise 5.1. Okay. In first part only this much is there and then representation of the fraction is there. See that. Represent the following fraction in your notebook using any plane figure. As I have represented this 2 upon 8. In this way you have to take any figure and you have to represent these geometrical figure. Means 3 upon 5. Exercise 5.1. 3 upon 5 I have to represent by any figure. So what we will do, beta? We will take a square. Okay. Or in how many part we will divide it? See that. One, two, three, four, five. In 5 part we have divided. How many part you have to take on? 3 part you will take out. So I have shaded that. So that it may not be confusion, or you will make it color, because here it is not possible that I will do it color. So what will be? This will represent your 3 upon 5. This will represent your 3 upon 5. The whole thing I have divided into 5 part, and out of 5 part, 3 part I have taken out. So this will be represent 3 upon 5. So 2 upon 7. 2 upon 7 also you have to represent. So for representing 2 upon 7, what you can do, just do, take a circle, okay, or divide it in how many parts? In 7 part you can take out, okay. 4 parts are there, then it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And now, see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 or 7 part I have divided. Out of that, how many part you have to take? 2 part. So you just take 2 part. So this will represent the fraction 2 upon 7. So in this way, rest of the questions of this one, for exercise 5.1, you will do yourself. Okay. Now we are, this time you have to, this fraction, for the given fraction, you have to make the figure. Okay. For the given fraction, you have to represent them by the figure. And in next question, what you have given, you have to given the figure and you have to write them in fractional form. Maybe all of you are clear. Here we have to given fraction, we have to make the figure for them. Now in next question, what we have given, we have to given figure and we have to write the fraction for that. Okay, now we are coming to the question number 2, means B part of exercise 5.1. See that now B part, this figure is given to you in your first question in A part. Okay, see that it was a rectangle, or in how many part it has divided? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And in how many parts it is color? 4. So numerator upon denominator. Numerator, what I told you, means taken part. Upon denominator means total part. Total parts. Okay. Now see that what, how many parts C has taken out? 4 part. And in how many parts the total the figure has divided? 6. So what will be its fraction? 4 upon 6. So in this way you will complete B part. See that B part is a figure like that. Figure is like that, okay, and out of that 4 part, this much of part he has colored in this way. If you can see 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4, okay, if you will see in how many parts the figure has divided, you can see beta, it is divided 1, 2, 3, 4 or 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 4 in 16 part. And how many part have color only? 4 parts are color. So, colored part is equal to 4 upon total part is equal to 16. So, what will be your fraction value? 4 upon 16. So, in this way, these kinds of question you have done in earlier class also. So, I am not going to do further rest of the part of this question. You will do yourself. So, now we are moving to the next one. We are moving to the next one, that is equivalent fraction. Equivalent fraction. Now see that beta, these are few important definitions after this exercise 5.1, that was very small exercise. Now some important definition which we have learned in previous class 4th also, equivalent fraction. And what are the equivalent fraction? A fraction is said to be equivalent fraction if it is multiplied, whether it will be multiplied or divided by the same number in the numerator and denominator. Means if any fraction's numerator, whether it will be multiplied by the same number or divided by the same number, then whatever value will come, that will be the equivalent of the previous fraction. See that, for example, 1 upon 2 is there. If 1 upon 2 will be multiplied by 2 upon 2, then 2 upon 4 it will be the equivalent to 1 upon 2. Not only by the 2, you can take 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, whatever you would like to take. Okay, and for example, 4 upon 12 is there. If 4 upon 12, you know that 4 and 12 both are coming in the table of 3. If I will divide its numerator and denominator by the 4, 4 upon 4, so you can see that 4 1 ja 4, 4 3 ja 12. So 1 upon 3 is equivalent to 4 upon 12. So these kinds of fractions are known as the equivalent fraction. Many more examples are also given in your book. You can see from there also. You will note down all these definitions in your copy. Then next fractions comes that like fractions. The fractions which have same denominators are called like fractions. For example, 1 upon 2, 3 upon 2, 4 upon 2, or 3 upon 5, 4 upon 5, or 1 upon 5, etc. So, and what is the other property of the like fraction? If we will have like fraction, at that time we don't, no need to take any LCM. Directly we can add or subtract the like fractions. What I said, that directly we can add or subtract the like fraction. But if denominators are unequal, then you know that what we are doing, we are taking LCM and then first we are making their denominators equal. Lot of questions I taught in last year and maybe slowly slowly it will remind you. Now next is proper fraction. What is that? Proper fraction. Okay, and what is proper fraction? A fraction in which numerator is smaller than denominator. I have written in the form of numerator and denominator. Numerator is less than denominator is called proper fraction. For example, you can see 1 is smaller than 2, 3 is smaller than 4, 5 is smaller than 7. Then these kind of fractions are known as the what? Proper fraction. What they known? Proper fraction. Okay? Proper fraction. Our second definition comes improper fraction. A fraction in which denominator will be greater than numerator. They are known as improper fractions. For example, if you can see that 13 upon 5, 12 upon 3, 16 upon 5. In all these examples, you can see that numerator upper part is smaller, greater than the lower one, means denominator. So these are the improper fractions. These are the improper fraction. And improper fraction can be converted into mixed fraction. You know that. If I will make the division of 5 in 13, what, how many times it go? 5 to the 10. What will remain? 3 as remainder. Then how we are writing them in mixed fraction? Quotient, remainder upon divisor. And what is quotient? 2, 3 upon 5. If we will simplify, then 13 upon 5 it will come. 5 to the 10. 10 plus 3, 13 upon 5. In this way, they are, and this form is known as the mixed fraction. This is known as the mixed fraction. Why we know this is known as the mixed fraction? One complete value. 1, 2 is a complete number. Whole number we know. Okay. 2 is a whole number and 3 upon 5 in a, in which form? In proper fraction form. So, this kind of fractions are known as the mixed fraction. Okay. Now see that, beta. Numerator upon denominator is always equal to the fraction. Means fraction can be written in the form of numerator upon denominator. Now in question number 1, exercise 5.2, you have given numerator is equal to 6. So, where you will write 6? In top upon. Denominator is how much? 6. So what will be the fraction value? Fraction is equal to 6 upon 7. So in this way they are very simple. Different numerators and denominators are given to you. So you will do this question yourself, because all the children will enjoy this question. Everybody can do this question yourself. So I am not doing the rest of the part of this question. It is very simple. So you will perform this question yourself. Now what is the question number 2, beta? Question number 2 is that proper fraction, improper fraction and mixed fraction. Okay. Proper fraction, again I am repeating, in proper fraction, numerator is less than denominator. Now anything you can select. Select numerator smaller than denominator, 2 upon 7. Okay, it will be which fraction? Proper. Now improper. Suppose improper I have selecting, means in which denominator is greater than the numerator, is greater than the denominator. Okay, now select. Reverse it, 7, you know, if we will write 7 on the top numerator and denominator for making, what it will become? Is equal to improper. Now convert into improper fraction, can be converted into mixed fraction. So for mixed fraction, I am teaching by the same example so that you may understand the problem. Okay, now what you will do? Do the division of 2 in 7. 2, 3 ja 6. What will be remainder? 1. So mixed fraction, mixed, proper, improper can be converted is equal to mixed fraction into mixed fraction. See that now. What I told you, by which formula? Quotient, remainder upon divisor. This is your remainder. This is your quotient. See that. What is quotient? 3. What is remainder? 1. What is divisor? 2. It will be the value of mixed fraction. So, in this way, your question number 2 also have completed. Note down till question number 2 in your copy. Okay. Then write the 3 fractions equivalent to the given fraction. Equivalent fractions. What was the definition of equivalent fraction? If we will multiply or divide the fraction by the different, means same number in the numerator and denominator, then they are known as the which fractions? Equivalent fraction. So here I am multiplying it by 2 upon 2. So what it will become? 2 1 ja 2 upon 4 is first equivalent fraction. How many fractions equivalent we have to write? 3. Then again 1 upon 2. Multiply it by 3 upon 3. What it will become? 3 1 ja 3. 3 2 ja 6. It is second equivalent fraction. Second equivalent fraction. Okay. Third one is again 1 upon 2. Multiply it by 4 upon 4. Then 4 1 ja 4. 4 2 ja 8. Is equal to third. This is third one equivalent fraction. Third equivalent fraction. Okay. So you have seen how much simple is it is there. You have done all these kinds of, means this chapter earlier in class 4th also. Okay, one more B part I am doing. That is 5 upon 6. Here division is not possible in these one. If division will be possible, then we can do division also. But here in 5 and 6, no common factor is there. So we cannot make division in this one. So you multiply it by first, by this time I am starting from 2 upon 2. What it will become? 5 2 ja 10. 6 2 ja 12. It will be first equivalent fraction. I am not writing now. You will write yourself. Then 5 upon 6. Next time I am multiplying by 5 upon 5. By any number I can multiply. It is not that always 1, 2 and 3. It depends on my choice that what number I am selecting. 5 5 ja 25. 6 5 30. It will be second equivalent fraction. Third one is 5 upon 6 multiplied by 7 upon 7. I have taken 7 5 35, 6 7 42. It will be your third equivalent fraction. So how much simple they are. Okay, in this way till question number third, till equivalent fraction. Now here till equivalent fraction exercise 5.2, all the children will complete your work from where we have started today's class, from Roman numerals. And in you, I have questions from Roman numerals also. You have questions from the chapter Roman numerals also. Then we have learned types of fraction. What is the meaning of fraction? Okay. And what types of fraction? Improper fraction, proper fraction, mixed fraction. How we are converting improper fraction into mixed fraction. All these things we have learned. Then what are the equivalent fractions? Means up to all types of questions we have learned. So you just complete up to 5.3 till question number third. All the children will complete up to here your work. Okay. Then from next class, if you will have doubt, you can put in your WhatsApp group. And otherwise, we will start from the next time from question number 4th of same exercise. Till that, thank you and Jai Gurudev to all of you.